training horses, it all takes time. And as you're working on these things and riding your horse, you need to also remind yourself it takes time and to tell yourself, I have the time. And riding in awareness and being a thinking rider. Release is the key to softness. So, that's all right. Harley, the reason why I'm not teaching your horse to have a headset by just holding with both hands and bracing, because what happens is you're bracing, you got your elbows on your side, and you will start to create a horse that starts bracing. So you guys are both bracing on each other. And then, so Harley, don't even worry about your legs anymore. We're just gonna work on the head down cue, which will create lightness, which will create softness. So before I was showing you is you squeeze head down, inside rein. Squeeze head down. Ooh. We're not going to do that anymore. All you need to worry about is inside rein, drop your head. Inside rein. So we have lateral flexion, both directions. He understands that. To the left. Vertically. Good. Now the key to softness is the release. That's the only way we can communicate with the horse. So don't worry about your legs. Just inside rein, drop your head. Now like I told you before, the outside rein is a supporting rein. If we're talking about including the legs, your legs would also help support. We're only going to talk about from the wither forward with you and Kip right now. So, inside rein, drop your head. Outside rein will control the size of your circle. It will control his shoulder from moving out. Good boy. And you can also, inside rein, you can use it to get him to tuck his nose in. Good. So first what you need to do is do it all at a standstill, which he just showed that he knows how to do that. So you can just sit on your horse and practice this and play with this to get him soft. Just have my legs just on him. They're not doing anything. Good boy. Let him know he's doing good. Praise him. Inside rein, drop the head. So you can sit here and play with your horse and see how low you can get that head. It's just real simple. Just one rein. Drop. Nice. Release. Nice. Boy, nice, really nice, Kip. All right, so I want you to be a thinking rider and to ride in awareness. And it's important to you to start the headset and having Kip more soft. So before you do any next transition, say a walk, again, you're gonna ask Kip for his head, inside rein. Say, I'm gonna go to the right. My legs aren't doing anything. Inside rein, walk on. Good. this horse perfect distance around that cone. Go inside rein, drop the head. Nice. Outside rein is supporting the sides of the circle. I can use it to talk to him to ask him to lower his feet and his nose also to tuck it in. Now you see how Kip is walking kind of fast? There we go. I would have asked him if the reins to slow down. His head's coming up, so hold your inside rein, head down. Now I want to whoa, and I would like to have him whoa with his head down. So I'm going to be a thinking rider. Inside rein, head down. I'm going to go in front of this cone. I'm going to sit and open my legs. Keep your legs open for the back up. Keep them soft. Give, take, give, take. The only time he stops backing is when I close my legs back on his barrel, and that is the cue to stop backing. Now I'm going to go the opposite direction. I'm going to be a thinking rider. So I'm going to think inside rein, head down. Do not do anything with your legs. And go the other direction. The key again to the softness is all in the release. So whoa, inside rein, open your legs, whoa, keep your leg off them for the back up. Give, take, give, take, give, take. Legs stay off until I want them to stop. Then I close my legs on his barrel. That's the cue to whoa. See, I don't know if I'm still in the screen. So you see how his head pops up? That's okay. It's another chance to have a conversation with them. There you go. Good. So you'll do this over and over and over and over. And he's just going to keep getting better. And you're just going to keep getting better. And then the next, you will transition doing this to the trot. And then after that, to the lope. Inside rein, drop your head. Outside rein, supports the shoulder. Walk around. Now, once you get really good at this, you could ask your horse for more flexion. So you could do inside rein, outside rein, and see if you can get him to tuck to his shoulder. And walk a couple steps. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, release. The release again is the conversation that he did it right. So I'm going to ask again, inside rein, outside rein, ask him to tuck his nose in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There's more steps. Release. Walk on. Inside rein. Ask for a feet. Open your legs. Whoa. Legs off for the back up. Your legs off them until you want them to stop. Now I close my legs on his barrel. You took a couple steps, so I'm going to take them back. Open my legs, ask Kip to back. Close my legs. Now I'll go in the opposite direction again. So thinking rider, inside rein, drop your head. Now again, if you want to practice him becoming more soft in the front, you could go more inside rein, outside rein, ask him to tuck his nose to his shoulder. And see how he dropped, he got soft and dropped his nose. I want that to him. Just keep give and take, give and take. Pick up a new mouth. Hold, 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 give. Hold, 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 give, and drop. Nice, Kip. Hold, 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 good. When his head goes up, follow it. Inside rein, drop your head. Inside rein, drop your head. Good boy. Legs off, ask him to back. Give to him, take. Give, give. He's doing it on his own. Give, ask for more.